Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Learn. So if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon to get the latest notification. Okay, so today we are going to start a new topic, that is theories of international trade. So there are about 5 to 6 theories, but today we are focusing on mercantilism theory and absolute advantage theory in 10 minutes, and the remaining will be in the next video. Okay, so let's start the video. So first one is mercantilism theory. So this theory focuses on export and import of gold and silver. It is stated that the gold and silver only as the wealth of a nation and not the value of goods and services. So a country will be a wealthy country if it has a more of gold and silver, and they are not measured on the basis of value of goods and services provided by that nation. So by exporting goods, country receive gold, and by importing, they are losing gold. So to become a wealthier nation, what a country focuses on? The country focuses more on exporting rather than importing. We can understand this better with the help of an example. Okay.
Or we can say the example of a mercantilism theory. Okay. So there is a country A. Okay. Country A who has gold. We can say that 10 gold coins. Okay. 10 gold coins. And country A is producing clothes. Okay. So country A has 10 gold. And country A is producing clothes. Okay. And there is a country B. Country B who has 20 gold. Okay. And country B needs clothes. So, what country A will do? Country A will export these clothes to country B. Export this clothes to country B. So, in return, country B will have to pay the gold. So, suppose country B is paying 10 gold. Okay. So, what will happen? In total, country A will have 20 gold and country B will have 10 gold. So, in this case, we can say that country A is exporting clothes, and at the viewpoint of country B is importing clothes from them. So, here we can say that while exporting, the country is gaining more gold, and while importing, they are losing their gold. Okay. So, in a mercantilism theorem, a country focuses to retain more gold or to gain more gold. Okay. So, what the country will be promoting? Country will be promoting more of export than import. Okay. So, this is how mercantilism theory works. Okay. Hope you got it.
So, the next theory is absolute advantage theory. Okay. So, absolute advantage theory was given by Adam Smith. He explains that a country should export those goods which can be produced more efficiently in the home country and import the goods which can be produced more efficiently in other countries. Okay, suppose our country is very efficient in producing wheat, then we have to produce more wheat and export wheat. Okay, and if our country is not much efficient in producing sugar, we must not produce sugar in our country. Instead, we should import the sugar to our country. Okay, that is what absolute advantage theory explains. So there are three main assumptions. First assumption is that there are two countries, and the second assumption is there are two commodities, that is one commodity to export and one commodity to import, and there is only one factor, that is we are taking labor as the main factor here. So let us also understand this absolute advantage theory with the help of an example.
Example of absolute advantage theory. Okay, so here we are taking two country, that is India and Brazil. Okay, and we are taking two products, that is sugar and tea. Okay, so assuming that there is only one employee, and that one employee can produce 5 kilo of sugar in India and 10 kilo of tea in India. Okay, and one employee in Brazil can produce 10 kilo of sugar and 5 kilo of tea in Brazil. So from this example, it is clearly seen that India is more efficient in producing tea than sugar. And Brazil is more efficient in producing sugar rather than tea. So according to absolute advantage theory, what these countries should do? India should produce tea as it is more efficiently produced in India. So India should produce tea and import sugar from Brazil. Okay, import sugar from Brazil. And what Brazil should do? Brazil should produce sugar and import tea from India. So absolute advantage theory states that a country should produce the good which can be more efficiently produced in their country and should import the good which can be less efficiently produced. So here in this example, India is more efficient in producing tea. So India should produce tea and import sugar from Brazil. And Brazil is more efficient in producing sugar. So Brazil should produce sugar in their country and should import tea from India. So this is an example of absolute advantage theory. Hope it is clear to you all.
So today we discussed two topics, that is mercantilism theory and absolute advantage theory. In mercantilism theory, we studied that only gold and silver are given importance and the country more focuses on gaining more gold or keeping their gold with themselves. So they focus on more of exporting rather than importing. And in absolute advantage theory, we learned that absolute advantage theory was given by Adam Smith, and he states that a country should produce goods that can be more efficiently produced by them and should import the less efficiently produced good from other country. Okay, so hope both these theories are clear to you all. So we can learn comparative advantage theory, HO theory and product life cycle theory in the next video. So that's all for today, and this topic was suggested by Rekhasri. So a big shout out to Rekhasri. Thanks so much for suggesting a beautiful topic, and you all can also participate in this by just commenting down the topics you want, and I'll be making a video on it soon. So a big shout out to Rekhasri. Thank you so much. So if you like the video, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with all the commerce students you know. And please give your precious feedback into the comment section. And if you have not subscribed to Let's Learn, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get the latest notification. I'm uploading a commerce video on a daily basis. So please subscribe and click the bell icon. Okay. So for more commerce topics, keep watching Let's Learn. Thank you.